you know that we've enhanced login security for CloudIQ by letting you federate with your company's identity provider, or IDP? Hi, my name is Derek Barbosa, and today I'll walk through the steps required to configure the federated identity single sign-on feature in CloudIQ. Single sign-on is becoming the mainstream way to authenticate for many modern enterprises. It allows customers to use their corporate credentials as the preferred way to authenticate signing into CloudIQ. SSO also enables multi-factor authentication through the customer's IDP to provide an additional layer of security. The configuration process begins under the Single Sign-On tab in the Identity Management page. Note that the CloudIQ user must be a CloudIQ admin to have access to Identity Management. The CloudIQ admin sends an email invitation to one or more of the identity experts at your company to become a Dell Identity Admin. The identity expert should have the ability to configure IDPs. Each identity expert receives an email invitation with a link to sign into the Dell Identity Portal. The identity expert enters the email address to which the invitation was sent and will then receive a one-time password to complete the login. When the identity expert enters the one-time password, they are logged into the Dell Identity Portal. The first step is to create an IDP group. In this example, the group is already created. The customer must then verify the domain associated with the email address that was used for the invitation. When the domain is verified, a small green checkmark is associated with the domain. This indicates to Dell that the customer has proven ownership of the domain. Authenticating the domain uses an industry standard of domain trust text code that needs to be applied to the customer's domain DNS records. After the domain is verified, the customer can step through the wizard to configure their IDP from the dashboard. The customer enters the configuration name and selects their domain or domains from the list of verified domains. Dell provides the service provider metadata on the SP metadata tab. This data is applied to the customer's identity provider. From this tab, the customer can copy the metadata values individually or download the entire XML file. Next, on the configuration tab, the customer specifies whether the IDP is using SAML or OpenID Connect. Currently, only SAML is supported. OIDC will be supported in a future release. Select the authentication method, which is either service provider initiated or IDP initiated. Service provider initiated is the default. The next step is for the customer to upload the IDP metadata to Dell. The customer can upload the metadata as a single XML file or enter it as single values. The basic SAML information is the entity or connection ID and the name ID format. Dell also requires the single sign-on endpoint, either from HTTP POST or HTTP redirect. The customer then provides the SAML signing certificate. As the final step on the SP metadata tab, the customer identity expert provides the four standard claims that Dell requires. They are first name, last name, primary email, and unique user identifier, or UUID. If the UUID is not mapped, it will default to the primary email. The next tab is user group. This is optional and allows the customer to configure user groups that can be used with a future group-to-role mapping feature called AuthZ that is still under development. The last step is to test the IDP connection. When the test connection is valid, the IDP can be activated. It takes approximately 40 minutes for the caches at Dell to refresh. At that point, Dell enables SSO for the IDP. When the IDP is activated, SSO is enabled. At that point, customers accessing CloudIQ will be required to use the SSO login. As an SSO user, a new sign-in behavior occurs when logging into CloudIQ. When the user enters their email address, if the domain is recognized as associated with an SSO-enabled account, the password field is removed. Clicking Continue redirects the user to their own company's IDP for authentication. Upon successful authentication with the customer's IDP, the user is redirected back to CloudIQ with an SSO-enabled session. This concludes today's demo of CloudIQ Federated Identity SSO configuration. For more information, visit CloudIQ on Dell Technologies and the Dell Technologies Info Hub, shown here and in the video description. Thanks for tuning in.